Debbie was here. Debbie was here.
Oi!
What?
Don't let that mistress catch you doing that. She's on the lookout for all the naughty kids. She's planning these corridors for Monday.
Good job, school's out soon then, innit?
Yeah.
Join us for Deal or No Deal here in the Dream Factory all next week.
Tony!
Let's go with number 20, Loz.
This is one of those truly huge boxes in your game. Your only chance to play Deal. All the months and months that you've been preparing yourself for this, the waiting, all of that goes to nothing if we see you know what. Thank you, Loz.
1p in here, Tony, I'm sure. Good luck, buddy.
Thank you, Loz.
Good luck. Why do you think the nation should return to your game here at school?
Blobby and Noel back on TV. It's like history happening.
Yeah. All right. Come back anyway. Thank you for mentioning the B word.
Deal. Or no deal.
Thank you, Mr. Banker. It's been an absolute pleasure. No deal.
Are you about to take £3,000 out of that man's wallet? I really hope so. That would be a good reward for the commitment you've shown. It was not to be.
Take fat.
I think they're in there somewhere.
We're 1,000 miles apart, but you know I love you.
It's back for Pud, which is serving in his own special way.
Ladies and gents, back for Pud is served.
That's it.
All right, madam, Connie and Piers, look at this. I'd chuck one of them in there like that for you, lovely. You can have chocolate bits as well, Molly.
How much brandy did you put in this?
14 bottles.
And congratulations, because you won the show.
I know, I don't know how.
It was because you were a brilliant host, and it was because you had a whole menu of exciting things. I think the proper vote winner, though, was your chicken korma, which you like to call...
Korma be magic.
Because you are such a take that fan.
I'm a huge fan.
Was a serious musician in here.
Yeah.
And also a serious chef.
Well...
This recipe is complicated, not...
It's difficult.
So... What are you going to do? Chop up
right,
the chicken breast?
Literally, korma would be mad. It's a chicken korma. It's that simple. And to be honest, if it was any more complicated...
And I'll just run through the ingredients.
Yes,
obviously, a little
of course.
Bit of oil to fry the diced chicken breast
That's
in.
Right, we can put that in now,
you
actually.
You then add a jar of ready-made korma sauce.
Ready-made.
That's the only way to go.
Yeah.
You add a little bit of sugar.
Just a little, quite a lot of sugar with me.
Desiccated coconut.
Yep.
A small amount of cream.
Yep.
And that is Bob's your auntie.
That's literally it. Yeah. I mean, it doesn't get more complicated than that, to be honest. But, you know, my night on the show last night, I wasn't on about cooking complicated food. I wasn't, you know, I just wanted to have a nice party.
And you did.
And I wanted them to relax and enjoy it. Almost all of them enjoyed it, apart from...
Nicholas. He was horrible.
Foul.
Did you punch him?
No. I'm not that sort of bloke. And I thought, well, to be honest, he's done the damage himself. He's going to go on and look stupid and... I can just keep smiling and, you know.
Tony, here is Nicholas. No, I'm joking. Come on.
I came prepared.
Yes. You start cooking.
Yes, I'm going to chuck it in there.
Catch up with Tony's progress with his korma be magic.
Absolutely.
Chicken korma a little bit later. Now, after the break. This is Tony James, a.k.a. Blobby Williams from Take Fat. It'll all come clear at the end because we'll be watching him. He's busy concocting the chicken korma, which is looking pretty good.
Looks all right.
Yeah, it looks lovely.
Look at that. Naan breads are in.
Are they?
Rice is on.
Did you buy those from Frozen? Maybe.
Maybe.
Okay. And also Eliza Doolittle is getting...
Please welcome Take Five!
Ladies and gentlemen, Jason Chocolate Orange, Blobby Williams, Gary Lardo, Howard McDonald's, and Mark Growing.
And Blobby Williams. Who was your favourite?
Blobby Williams.
Oh, just like in real life.
One of them is now an international superstar. But what happened to the other four? Tonight, we find out as we bring them all together for the first time in 10 years.
Keep you waiting.
A little bit.
I blame Nigel. One night after a show, he slipped a wrap into my hand. Duck and hoisin. There's no going back after that. Before you know it, I was on pasties, bagels, Mountain Mowbrays. Not every meal's a happy meal.